was stiff, and Elizabeth Grafenberg Schaefer, our Mother Francis, officially began our Franciscan community that we know today as the Sisters of St. Francis of Tiffin, Ohio. How fitting on this feast of the Sacred Heart that we gather together as family members and friends here in St. Joseph Church, where Father Ben was the pastor and Elizabeth Schaefer was a parishioner. You might want to note that the chalice that Bishop Thomas will be using today was Father Ben's chalice. We are so grateful to the members, especially those early members of St. Joseph Parish, who generously shared Father Ben with his endeavor of starting a home for orphans and elderly who needed care after the Civil War. That was an endeavor that both Father Ben and Mother Francis heard through the words of Jesus. Whatever you do for the least of these, you do for me. These gospel words continue to be our guide as we balance prayer and action through caring for God's creation, peacemaking, and being concerned for people who are poor. Today, we sisters thank you who have journeyed with us throughout all these years. And we most especially thank our God for calling our founders and for guiding our members of the community throughout these years. We continue to learn and to profess the words that are engraved in Latin over our front door. God is our refuge and our strength. I invite you to join me prayer and in song this morning by using the worship aid on this, the solemnity of the Most Sacred Heart of Jesus.
Thank you. the most sacred heart of Jesus. The very liturgical day, 150 years ago, and the Sisters of St. Francis of Tiffin were founded by Father Joseph Nin and by Elizabeth Schaefer, later Mother Francis. How blessed we are to offer this Mass, thanking the Lord for the blessings of 150 years and presenting it anew the intentions and the work of all of our Francis and sisters. Dear brothers and sisters, let us now acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to my Pray for me to the Lord. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that we glory in the heart of your beloved Son, and recall the wonders of his love for us. May we be made worthy to receive an overflowing measure of grace from that flood of heavenly gifts. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Ezekiel. Thus says the Lord God, I myself will look after and tend my sheep. As a shepherd tends his flock, when he finds himself among the scattered sheep, so will I tend my sheep. I will rescue them from every place where they were scattered, when it was cloudy. I will lead them out from among the peoples and gather them from the foreign lands. I will bring them back to their own country and pasture them upon the mountains of Israel, in the lands with leaves and all its inhabited places. In good pastures will I pasture them, and on the mountain heights of Israel shall be their grazing ground. There they shall lie down on good grazing ground, and in rich pastures shall they be pastured on the mountains of Israel. I myself will pasture my sheep. I myself will give them rest, says the Lord God. The lost I will seek out. The strayed I will bring back, the injured I will bind up, the sick I will heal, but the sleek and the strong I will restore, shall feed them rightly. The word of the Lord.
Yeah.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, the love of God has been poured out into our hearts through the Holy Spirit that has been given to us. For Christ, while we were still helpless, died at the appointed time for the ungodly. Indeed, only with difficulty does one die for a just person, though perhaps for a good person one might even find courage to die. But God proves his love for us in that while we were still sinners, Christ died for us. How much more then, since we are now justified by his blood, will we be saved through him from the wrath? Indeed, if while we were enemies, we were reconciled to God through the death of his Son, how much more, once reconciled, will we be saved by his life? Not only that, but we also boast of God through our Lord Jesus Christ, through whom we have now received reconciliation. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
heart speaks to heart. Today, as with the whole church, we celebrate the solemnity of the most sacred heart of Jesus. We celebrate a heart speaking to a heart, perhaps in three ways. First, the heart of God revealed in the very heart of Jesus Christ, pierced on the cross for love of us, speaks to his church today, throughout the whole world, on this solemnity. And today, extraordinarily, not in small part due to Francis in planning, what a gift that on the very liturgical feast of the founding of the Tiffin Franciscans, we gather on that feast, the Sacred Heart, to mark 150 years. Only 13 years before that date was this solemnity put in the church's liturgical calendar. But on this date and in this place, we celebrate a heart of God, the heart of Jesus, speaking to the heart of the Tiffin Franciscan community. And we have a third heart. You know, whenever my dad was supposed to tell me something that my mom wanted him to tell me about her, she would always say, "Your dad's going to have a heart-to-heart with you." And I knew it was going to be serious. But she too had heart-to-hearts with me. And they were always loving, as were my father's. Today, in this solemnity, heart speaks to heart. The heart of Jesus to the heart of each one of us here this morning. Each Franciscan sister, each third order, each volunteer, each associate, each friend in the community. Heart of Jesus speaking to our individual hearts. We cannot possibly imagine other than the fact that Father Joseph Bin and Elizabeth Schaefer, after 13 years already of celebrating the Feast of the Sacred Heart, were inspired spiritually to make the founding day on the Feast of the Sacred Heart. How beautiful that we celebrate this day in the very place here in Tiffin, in St. Joseph's Parish, where the order was founded. How beautiful that we have the privilege today for me to use the very chalice of Father Joseph Bin to offer Holy Mass as he probably offered it 150 years ago for that first communion. And how beautiful that we have the opportunity to see in the sacred scriptures that we've heard the mission of the Franciscan sisters as it now serves the church. Now I must tell you, Sister Sarah and sisters, you know that you were before the Diocese of Toledo began. Because we know this is the Diocese of Cleveland, right? And we know that only later was the Diocese of Toledo founded, and apparently Bishop Schrems was so jealous of the Franciscan sisters, he called them all back to the territories outside of the diocese because he wanted them for himself. And for all these years, the Tiffin Franciscans have served not just here, but in so many other hospitals, serving in the spirit of Francis and Claire. In the first reading we heard from the book, of the prophet Ezekiel, when we hear these words, we can almost think that this is the mission of the Franciscan sisters, isn't it? Following the Good Shepherd to seek out the lost, the strayed I will bring back, the injured I will light up, the sick I will heal. striven to do just that. We cannot help but imagine that even if the solemnity of the Sacred Heart is already in place when Father Joseph Vindman and Elizabeth Schaefer became the co-founders, many years before, we are certain that the heart of Jesus spoke to the heart of Francis and to the heart of Claire so that they would respond to the need of the Church for a more vibrant and a more authentic proclamation of the Gospel. In the second reading of St. Paul, the very first words we hear, the love of God has been poured out into our hearts through the Holy Spirit that has been given to us. The love of God poured out to us through the pierced heart of Jesus on the cross, from which blood and water flowed, a symbol of the sacrifice and the founding of the Church, and now a symbol of the love and mercy that Jesus extends to all of us. And in the Gospel, according to Luke, we hear about seeking out the one, even though there were another 99. Francis and Claire sought the most needy. They weren't at all troubled by leaving the 99 to find those who were lost. Not just lost materially, but lost spiritually. And so from the heart of Christ Jesus and from the heart of the Church, our Tiffin Franciscan sisters continue to reach out to the lost, surely those who are lost materially, but certainly those who are lost spiritually. Heart speaks to heart. Today, a beating, human, loving heart of Jesus Christ continues to beat in love for his Church. Heart speaking to the heart of the Church. Today, a beating, human, loving heart continues to speak to the Tiffin Franciscan community so that they might know his love and extend that love to those who they serve. And today, a beating, human, loving heart of Jesus speaks to each one of our hearts, inviting us to open our hearts ever more widely to his love and mercy. It must not be any coincidence that in my research I couldn't find anything specific, but it must not be a coincidence that Father Ben and Elizabeth Schaefer, Mother Francis, chose the words, the Sisters of Penance and Charity. Some might scratch their heads today and say, what in the world does one have to do with the other? We would say, everything. So that penance first for our own sins and failings, and second for reparation of the sins of the world, and then charity, extending the very love that the Lord gives to us, to our needy brothers and sisters. I can't think of a more perfect phrase to describe the love of the heart of Jesus. Penance and charity. So rejoicing today, dear sisters, we offer thanks and praise to the Lord for 150 years of your presence here on a hill in Tiffin, purchased 150 years ago by Father Ben with a vision to serve first orphans and those in need. May the next 150 be years of profound grace, and may all of us take consolation and find joy in a heart speaking to our hearts. As we celebrate the solemnity of the Sacred Heart, let us together confess our faith. I believe in one God, Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God. God from God made, consubstantial to the Father. Through him all things were made. Christ ascended for our salvation. He came down from heaven. And by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our Savior was crucified and religious Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended Grant your friends that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
Take this, all of you, and
and eat it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you.
Through him and with
churches to grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I give you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
Amen.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Thank you. May the blessing of